Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. This is not financial advice. I just hope you watch your oven mitts, baby, because it's about to get hot in the kitchen. Now, just know, family, I jam-packed this one with bangers, and I jam-packed this one with information, baby. It's Friday, and I just don't have it in my heart to leave you uninformed. Now, Discord family in particular, if you in the building, let me know in the comments, baby. I want to celebrate you. Everybody, what I want you to do is listen to this, because I jam-packed this one. We talking about Nio. We talking about AMC. We talking about BBIG. We talking about, basically, support.com. All of it, family. Let's talk about it. Let's break it down. The first one on the list, the first banger, is support.com. Now, I recently posted this on the watch list over on the Discord, and I posted this yesterday when it was $23, but some of the Discord family, I gotta salute y'all. Y'all been in this since it was even $4, $5. Man, let's get it, baby. Let's go. Now, why am I bringing this up? Currently, this is $26, but if you look at all of the facts, you'll see that this thing got as high as like $59, family. This thing was running up, and then it came all the way down. It had to cool off a little bit, and now it's $26. So currently, actually, it's $29. It's $29.96, up 33% on the day. It's up 218% on the week. However, it's up over 1,000% in the past year. I want you to understand, though, for the last like 5 to 8 years, this thing has been sleeping, family. It's been sleeping. But what's interesting about this play is I want you to see, because, you know, I tell you, if it's looking like a duck, it's quacking like a duck, it's potentially market manipulation. I want you to see this. When you go to the options on support.com, you may have been surprised. Why? Because, you know what, the stock got all the way up to the 50s, almost the 60s, but then you see no options in the $40 range, in the $50 range, in the $60 range, and even the options that are $34, $35, $36 at the strike. Guess what? These are still in the thousands of dollars, if not $2,000 per contract, family. Now, what usually happens when stocks run up, the market makers, the people who are in the background who add liquidity to the market, what they would do in this case is they would say, oh, the stock is all the way up here. It's time to start to add more contracts. And they're literally making all of these more contracts so we could buy a contract in the 50s, buy a contract in the 60s. But guess what? They haven't been doing that. Are they working on it in the background? You would think, because there's a lot of money for them to make here, that they would have already done it. But are they working with the short sellers? Who knows, family? I'll let you be the judge of that. Now, who is support.com, in case you didn't know? They provide customer and technical support for basically all kind of different things. And they do home-based and cloud-based technology platforms that basically outsource services. Got it. But if you look at their website, you'll see, what do they say about themselves on their investor relations page? It says they're a leading provider. Now, let's be clear on this. Whenever you hear somebody's a leading provider, everybody's saying they're a leading provider, but it is what it is. And it says, in customer and tech support solutions and security software with a global network of home-based experts. Now, what's happening too, actually, did this happen already? It may have happened already. I'm not sure. I got to double check on that. But it says the Bitcoin miner Greenidge Generations, basically in support.com, they announced the merger on March 22nd, 2021. I don't know if the merger totally went through yet, but I want you to keep your eye out for that. Now, let's take a look at this. They were identified for many, many, many times by many, many websites as a short squeeze candidate. But I want you to understand, there are many short squeeze candidates, but this is just one that happened to actually hit. And Benzinga said they've been talking about this in July 14th, back when this was 427. But if you go back and look in time, like go all the way go back, you'll see that everybody was saying, oh, look at Workhorse, look at this, look at Clove, look at blah, blah, blah. They give you 100 different ones, and then some of them hit. But it is what it is. Now, what are the big dogs doing? Just know the big dogs been loading up, even when this was in like the 19 range, all of it. It seems like they've been covering over time. Now, let's go to Yahoo Finance and look at some of the numbers in the background, because this is what made it a real candidate for what's going on right now. So, here we go. Notice that the float, these mean how many shares. So, there's two kind of ways to count shares. There's the shares outstanding. The shares outstanding are basically all of the shares of the company, every single share. But the float is what can actively be traded by like retail investors and things like that, like you and me. So, now, all of the outstanding shares, all of the shares that exist, 24 million. But, and this is the most updated on Yahoo Finance, the float, 9.3 million, family, 9.3 million. So basically, when you look at the short interest, meaning how much of the float is being shorted, basically it's 67%. And this was as of August 13th, so it could be even higher. There are estimates that it's over 74, 75%, family. Basically, they're saying almost this whole 9 million shares that can be traded is being sold short, meaning that the large institutions are betting against it mostly. Okay, so now, with everybody buying the shares up, this kind of forced them to have to cover it. But let's keep it going. I just checked yesterday on what the dark pool was doing with this stock. And just yesterday, there was $197 million in trading volume over there, basically in dollars. But now, just today, it's basically way up. It's $368 million in trading over there in the dark pool, family. Because I'm telling you, every time when they need to do something behind closed doors, you know they revert right back to the dark pool. Now, when you look at Ortex and their most recent update on this, they say that, and this was on 8/26, they said that the short interest is now 74.77%. So it's looking like the short sellers is really doubling down. And then when they updated us again today, basically at 12:59 p.m., right, they said this, and I highlighted it in red. It said short interest is basically down 1.7%. So what this could mean is that there is some covering of this play. Now, since it's only down 1.7% estimate, we'll see what happens on Monday or Tuesday so we get a more updated value. But it seems like some of the shorts have covered. But if it's only 1.4% of the shorts have covered, that has sent us all the way up to 50, family, come on, come on. We still got basically 70 more percent to go. So this is crazy. And again, don't get the fear of missing out. Don't get the fear of missing out. If you're in the Discord, come on. We're going to come over there. We're going to talk to you about it. I don't want you to get the fear of missing out because this play, it could be over. But guess what? There's no way to know that until we get to all of the facts. I doubt that it's over. I doubt that it's over. But we shall see, because I want you to understand. You can make money on the way up. And you can make money on the way down with buying a put option. But let's keep it going. And again, don't get caught up on this play could be over, because it could, it can't, we can't tell the future. But let's keep it going. Now, the cost to borrow the stock in new stocks basically went up basically from like in the high double digits to all the way to 347%. So this means the short sellers who are buying this, family, they basically got to pay even more to get more and short that into the market. But let's keep it going. I want you to see this. Let's talk about AMC. So AMC currently $40 a share. Some key levels I want you to see with AMC are as follows. So let me just click on this right here. So basically, I want you to see it at, let's call it $39. This is about a recent floor in the last week. $39 has been a recent floor in the last week. So right here, if you're looking to load up on shares or anything like that, then right here is a solid entry point. It's not the absolute optimal entry point, but it's solid for a first strike. Like I always tell you, if I got $300 and I wanted to get some skin in the game, I put my first 100 on right now, bow, and then if it went up or down, I would either average up or down with my next $200 left. Bow, bow. You already know how we doing, baby. But again, I really want you, I want to take a step back and I want to talk about support.com one more time, because I want you to understand whether it goes up or whether it goes down, there's money to be made there. You just got to be willing, because you already know scared money don't make no money. That's why I tell you, you need your oven mitts. High risk, high reward. Now, let's look over again at AMC Entertainment, and let's see that AMC, basically, the dark pool, they still blowing up over there in the dark pool, family. 64% of all trading on the 25th. Come on. We waiting for the SEC to clear this up. We'll see if they do it or not. Do you believe they'll do it? Let me know in the comments. I already got my opinion on it. But let's talk about the next banger on the list. And this is one that a lot of people have been running with. And it's BBIG. And it's Vinco Ventures. Now, currently, they are actually up in the last 5 years. They're up basically, let's call it 70%. But what I want you to understand, actually, that's not even true. They're actually down in the last 5 years. But 5 years ago, almost, well, in this case, 2018, because almost 5 years, I'm on a 5-year chart, if you can see this here. But in 2018, basically, they're down and they got all the way up to 941. But right now, family, they're at 614. But again, when you're watching this, it might be in the 7 range. It might be all over the place. This one is taking off like a rocket, because this one has high short interest too, just like the other one. And just know this. Screenshots floating around on the internet. Remember the threshold list with AMC? We got to give AMC a salute. How are people making money with Vinco, ticker symbol BBIG? How are people making money with, what is it, support.com? How are they making money with these things, family? Because of the knowledge that they learned from AMC. They learned about the threshold list. They learned about short sellers. They learned how the market manipulation is happening. And now we can fight back with the information that we have, because knowledge is power, family. Come on now. Now, some key levels I want you to look at for Vinco. It's basically this. And remember, this one is taking off to the moon so far. Now, again, don't FOMO in. Make sure if you get some skin in the game, it's just that. It's skin in the game, money you're willing to lose. This is a hot play. Now, here we go. 440 or 475 and 575, for whatever reason, it's been having a hiccup right there at the $75 or 70 5 cent range at each dollar mark. So be on the lookout for that when it gets into the sevens, when it gets into the eights. If they go into 775, 785, there might be some high frequency trading or some limit orders at these marks with the short sellers. Now, let's keep it going. I want you to see Nio. What's going on with Nio? Nio, the Chinese government, they're having a crackdown on tech IPOs. So again, long story short, family, I'm not even going to just talk it up. What I want you to understand is the Chinese government is basically making American shareholders basically wary and fearful of what's going on in the stock market and unsure of how the politics are going to impact the stock. So then this is keeping all of the Chinese plays down. Bye-bye, all of the other ones. But you know what, family? I see you on the Discord. And if you can't handle the heat of these hot stocks, then stay out of the kitchen and consider investing in the index funds. I love y'all. Take care.